So I want to thank everyone for coming today on a Makeup Friday. And let's just kind of go back to what we went over on Monday. This is mass communication and society. All right, so this is a dual discipline between communication majors that can get 6 credits or social science majors that can get another 6 credits. All right? So one of the things that we covered was what? The radio, the invention of the radio. Who was that? Miss
Marconi.
Giuliani Marconi, right? An Italian inventor. What year was that?
1928.
All right. What else did I go over?
We talked about the 5 forms of communication.
The 5 what?
5 forms of communication.
Okay. So we have the 5 different models of communication. What's the first one?
Interpersonal.
Intrapersonal. And that's communicating with who?
With yourself.
With yourself. Your thoughts, prayer, meditation. What's the second one?
Interpersonal.
And that's with who?
Two people.
Does it have to be people? Can it be a cat and an owner? Can that be interpersonal? Right? This doesn't necessarily have to be a human being, right? Mm-hmm. Interpersonal, it's just two entities communicating with each other. Can it be a baby playing with a doll? Ah, that's a good one, right? Can it be baby playing with a doll?
Right?
Yeah, there has to be some kind of interaction when you're doing interpersonal communication. But you could be in silence and still communicate with somebody, just as long as they're in your presence, right? You know, it could be nonverbal, it could be affectionate, touching. But what's the third one? What is it? Small group? That's between how many people?
3 to 12.
3 to 12, or 3 to, I'll take 10. And what's the one after that?
Public communication.
Public? Yeah, that's what?
Lecturer.
Yeah, lecturer, somebody giving a speech. And what's the last one? And this is the one that we're dealing with. The internet, cyberspace, creates a techno culture, technology. All right? So I'm wondering if it's necessary to know the history of the internet before we move forward with this course. Because it's kind of like grown exponentially. And now scholars and educators are just backtracking to see the effects that it has on society. No one's really slowing down to take a look at it. Because a lot of these programmers that developed it is like, they just moving it forward. Selling products on it, advertisement, writing programs, different applications. And they call it apps, right? Writing apps. Apps is nothing but like programs to get specific jobs done based on user needs. User. And who's a user? What is a user? Huh? Speak up.
Someone who's using the product.
Yeah, well, a user is applied to computer terminology, right?
Yeah.
Someone who's at the keyboard, mm-hmm. at the computer. Someone's at the computer, all right? Okay, so that's basically how this thing starts out, basically. So like I said, the book is written at the PhD level, it really is. You can tell that the author made extensive research to try to make it practical so society, you as educators and students can see what's going on. So that makes you an educated user, doesn't it? A well-informed user, you're not blind, you know, you're not a passive user. You're basically an educated user of computer technology, and you understand the history of it. So would you agree that at least 95% of the population just uses this these devices, right? And the internet, and really don't know the history of it, where it came from, right? From young people too. You know, middle-aged and older folks think it's them. No, young people too. So, can you say that a user could be equivalent to a slave? slave. A slave is usually someone that doesn't understand how something operates. Right? But to every slave, there's probably a master, right? Or a puppet. Manipulator. Manipulating the strings on a puppet. That's the master. The puppet master, right? Right?
Yeah.
The puppet master. And it's real. Okay. So, the description of this course. This seminar examines the interrelationship between media and the current social and political environment. Class discussions focus on the attitudes and values of a media, meaning film, television, radio, and print. Content and style of the information presented through the particular media and the impact of each media upon family, religion, education, and political economic institutions. Topics to be covered are as follows. The power of the media to change values and attitudes, reinforce stereotypes, and mold public opinion. Media as a mass market tool, commercial versus alternative media, ethics of production, censorship, media as a political tool, bias in news, and future developments in communications such as cable, TV, federal subsidies. A Life Arts project is required. So hopefully you've taken as prerequisites modes of analysis and an introductory level course in communications or social science. So what is the next important thing that you look at on a syllabus that ultimately results in a grade? What is it? The what?
The grading
rubric, right? So written assignments and participation. Attendance is part of participation. You can't participate if you're not here, all right? So that's 20%. Research paper, 20%. Midterm, 15. Final exam, 20%, and the LAP. Am I throwing some spot quizzes in there?
Oh, no.
Oh, you don't like the quizzes, right? All right? So on the 11th, we should have reviewed the syllabus, course objectives and policies, LAP research paper, handout, and discussion on the history of the internet, radio, and television. And did we look at Claude, Dr. Claude Anderson?
Yes.
That was powerful, right?
Yeah.
That was with Rock Newman, right? The Rock Newman show?
Yes.
Yeah, he's from Howard University. I played baseball with him. He was my third baseman. Let me see. And he was also the manager for Reddick Bowl from Brownsville, the heavyweight champ. So today, Friday makeup, we should be overview of mass communication, mass media, the mythology of technology. Is technology neutral? That's a good discussion. Is technology neutral? What does it mean for something to be neutral? Neutral. Speak up.
In the middle, not to pick a side.
Not to pick a side, right? Passive. Right. You just let things happen, right? You don't want to take sides either. You want to be neutral. You're right in the middle. So when you don't vote, is that being neutral or is just that being stupid?
Well, stupid first and then neutral
second. Right. So you should exercise your right to vote, right? As a citizen, right? And to put the right people in office, right? That's going to do for your community, right? So as you can see, we mentioned the word politics. Politics is in there, right?
Well, sometimes you vote and they don't count your vote.
Yeah, I know.
You know? And you become, what you call it when you feel disappointed? Is that somebody discourage you?
You feel like your vote doesn't count, but that's why you have to keep voting. So you don't feel discouraged and keep going out to do it. They're going to say your vote don't count, so you're discouraged. You're like, I keep going out here every election and my vote don't count. So I'm not going to do it anymore. And now who suffers? Our community. Because everybody else's community is going out to vote, regardless if they vote count or not, because they still want to use their voice. Yeah. They don't care. They still pay their taxes. They're going to still use their voice. Yeah. It's just our people, you know, sometimes we choose to be, you know.
That's correct. All right, so let's do some reading, right? Now, we're going to read carefully. Now, hopefully you can get the book as soon as possible. It is easy carrying on the bus, on the train. And you have to constantly read it, reread until you absorb it. Because I'm sure a lot of these terms are going to be new to you, you know, and ideas.